Namaskar, Sasrikal, good morning. This is Mohan Kumawat, English lecturer and motivational speaker. And today, just I want to wish the great birth anniversary of Lal Bahadur Shastri, 2nd of October. As the second person, we also celebrate Gandhi Jayanti. Both are celebrated on this day. But a few people are celebrating the birth anniversary of Lal Bahadur Shastri. Even they don't know about him. So today I want to share my ideas about Lal Bahadur Shastri and about his life. When was he born? What did he do? In which party he was belonged to? That. So remaining things and some untouched moments from his life, and I'm going to share that. So just first I talk about his earlier life. Lal Bahadur Shastri was born on 2nd of October 1904 at Mughalsarai, Varanasi, UP, as a state of India, and he was born there in a very middle class family, that you can see. And his father was Sarda Prasad Srivastav and his mother was Ram Dulari. He was married, his wife was Lalita Devi. He had six children, like that Suman, Kusum, Sunil, Ashok, Anil, and these are the six children he had. After that, he joined the Indian National Congress. He studied many writers, Indian writers and foreigner writers like Marx, Russell, Lenin. These writers he studied, and after he came to an effect to Gandhi. He just listened his speech and his ideology, a lot of things he captured his mind, and after he delivered the ideas. After that, he became the second Prime Minister of India, just after the sudden demise of Lal Bahadur, Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. When Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru was died, so after that, Lal Bahadur Shastri was just became the second Prime Minister of India. Just he took on in 1964, so he became the second Prime Minister of India. We celebrate, and we just celebrate this 2nd of October because of his ideology, because of his simplicity, because of his great virtues. In the history of India, a few people who have born with this simplicity, and either of them, this Lal Bahadur Shastri is one of the greatest personality of India ever we have seen. That in the simplicity we talk, you have seen the many leaders, we have seen the many politicians who belongs to the richest and the richest family, but he belonged to a very simple and the very poor family. Even I have some ideas, I read something about his life, that a small thing I just say, that when his children said to him that, "Papa, now you are the Prime Minister of India, so can you buy a car for us?" He said, "We don't have a house, just how can we buy a car?" But after all, just he want to complete the desire of his children. So just he said, "Sure." So he said to his secretary, "Now secretary, go and check my balance." Because on that time he wanted to buy a car, that Fiat car, and the cost of the car was 12,000. So he said to his secretary, "You go and check my bank balance, how much I have that." So the secretary went to the bank and went to the account and checked and returned and said that, "Sir, you have only 7,000. You have only 7,000. Now we required 5,000 more." So when his children came to know, just they said, "Papa, just don't require, we don't require this thing, so don't buy that. Because we don't have the we don't have money. So like that, not required. It does not required to buy that. So please don't buy. After he said, yes, I will buy. I'll buy it. I will take a loan. So he decided to take a loan from Punjab National Bank. So he took the loan, 5,000 rupees from Punjab National Bank and bought a car, the Fiat car in 2000. Unfortunately, before completing his loan, he died before 1 year. He died 11th January 1966 during the time of the Tashkent Pact, when he went to Pakistan and came back to India and just made a compromise that Pakistan and India became a good country and relationship can be improved. So he came back to India, and after during the time of that time he was died there. So before the 1 year completing his loan, he died. After Indira Gandhi came and she became the Prime Minister of India, so she declared that Lal Bahadur Shastri's the loan was taken will be paid and will be cleaned. So after that, the wife of Lal Bahadur Shastri, Mrs. Lalita Devi, she was a self-reliant woman. She said that no, I will pay the entire loan. I'll pay the complete debt. I'll pay the complete loan. Just I will pay from my pension. So after that, continues the four years, the loan was paid by the Lalita Devi, the wife of Lal Bahadur Shastri. Such kind of the family, such kind of the Prime Minister we had in the history of India, that is known as Lal Bahadur Shastri. You should know about him there. You should know his ideology. You should know about his nationalism. You should know about his right wing. So I hope that it will make you sure that who was Lal Bahadur Shastri, and we should learn some inspiration from his life, that he was the one of the great simple man and the ordinary who was born, who started from the base and became and reached, achieved the highest position of India, Prime Minister he became. So wish you all the best. This is the 114th birth anniversary of Lal Bahadur Shastri, and make you sure that this kind of the things will be happens in your life. You learn a lot of things. Wish you all the best. Thank you. Vande Mataram.